CAN signal improvement capable, also known as SIC, CIA 601-4 CAN transceivers. For over 30 years, the control area network, known as CAN, has been providing a low overhead and fault-tolerant interface for both automotive and industrial markets. Found in applications like e-bikes, elevators, factory floors, agriculture, commercial transportation, and of course passenger vehicles, CAN has become a very ubiquitous worldwide interface. CAN SIC, as defined in CIA 601-4, outlines additional capability for CAN FD transceivers. Although CAN FD transceivers are generally rated to 5 megabit per second data rates, most designers implement CAN FD at much lower data rates and in simpler topologies due to excessive bus signal ringing. CAN SIC, which is fully backward compatible with earlier CAN specifications, tightens the bit timing symmetry and loop delay specification to reduce the excessive ringing and to enable reliable 5 megabit per second data and support for more complicated star and ring topologies. Let's look at a basic demonstration of CAN SIC versus CAN FD. Here we have a 16-node network with both CAN SIC and CAN FD transceivers present. The transceivers are connected via multiple different length cabling in a star topology. For this demo, we will be transmitting and receiving CAN frames at 2 megabit per second and 5 megabit per second. We'll start with a look at what the data traffic looks like at 2 megabits per second. As you can see, there's excessive ringing on both CAN H and CAN L when running at 2 megabit per second via CAN FD. You may also see the signal glitch on the RXD signal. Both of these artifacts could cause signal reliability issues, especially on more complex networks than you see here. Now, let's take a look at the CAN SIC device under the same conditions. Via TI's ringing suppression technology, both the ringing and the glitch are no longer present, which greatly reduces any signal reliability issues that may be present when using CAN FD transceivers. At 5 megabit per second, the ringing and signal glitch are further amplified, with the glitch now crossing over the next transition period. The data integrity of this signal is problematic and will likely cause issues. CAN SIC reduces the noise and removes the glitch, providing reliable data transmission. CAN SIC can enable automotive applications to run faster and more reliable than ever before, and no PCB changes are required when transitioning from CAN FD. TI offers two distinct CAN SIC transceivers today. The TCAN 1462 is a standard 8-pin CAN SIC transceiver supporting low power standby and optional 1.8, 3.3, or 5-volt I/O for communication with your microcontroller of choice. It is pin-to-pin compatible with previous generations, including the TCAN 1044A-Q1 product family, while the TCAN 1463-Q1 is a drop-in replacement for the TCAN 1043A-Q1 and provides a 14-pin CAN SIC transceiver with sleep, wake, and inhibit functionality. Both solutions are available in three distinct packages, including SOP packaging, which enables the smallest automotive CAN transceiver available today. Whether you're looking to increase frame rates on cameras or improve your infotainment and in-cabin user experience, or just future-proof your design for higher data rates and complex topologies, CAN SIC devices from TI can help you get there. Please visit ti.com/CAN for more information. Thank you.